Hello everyone, in this video we are going to check an AI tool that's called Recraft that graphic designer can actually use to generate or recraft icons for their websites or business cards, and can also recraft cool t-shirt design and actually check them out right away using the mockup tool, all in the same AI artboard. But before we're gonna check that out, make sure to subscribe and comment and leave a like. Alright, so let's get to it. Alright, so let's go and open a browser and I will type recraft.ai. And as you can see, you can try this for free or you can log in if you have an account. I already have one, so I will log in using my Google. And as you can see, I already have like 4 projects in here. And down here you can find like a guide for you to know how to use this AI tool. But for us, we're gonna just go straight and create a new project. Alright, so what I really like about this AI application, the Recraft, is like this artboard first, and also these new tools that they have, mockup. It's really useful for like business cards or t-shirt design and things like that. So you can design something, and if you want to print it, you can create like an artboard or something, and you can put your design directly in the artboard or in like the t-shirt to see exactly how it will look like. And this can be really useful if you have a website even selling t-shirts. That's actually really nice. And the other thing is this image set that we're gonna actually try it now. So I'm just gonna one click on it. But first, before we're gonna do that, as you can see in here, we have 4 options: raster image and vector image and image sets and mockup. So whenever you click on one, it will take you inside that option. And when you click out of this image set, you will go back to create new. So it's like you create a new file or a new layer, basically. All right, so let's go back and select the image set, and I'm gonna zoom out using Control or Command while scrolling down. And as you can see in here, like it's an image set of 6, but you can even put like 2 or 3 and hit generate or recraft, and it will generate only 3 for, you don't need to actually put the 6. But this is really cool if you have a website or if you want to print something like a resume or something. You can have these little icons, you can generate them in here. So let's go actually and change the style. So I will one click on this picture art, and I'm gonna change the sign to icon, and let's go for something simple like color outline. And let's actually write some prompting. Let's go for like, let's go for smartphone icon, and the second one, let's go for like street address. So let's go for the third and write like website, and the fourth one, let's go for something like, let's say smartphone, street address, website, email, and the fifth, it will be like, let's actually put like magnifier just to see if it would be useful for a web for like a business card, but it's okay. And the last one, let's go actually put thunder bolt. All right, so we have very different icons in here. So we already specific that we want icon, so we don't have to write smartphone icon or something like that, only smartphone in here. And the other cool thing about this is it's actually, you can choose your own colors by going to this palette in here. You can choose your own layer colors in here, or you can create your own palette and save it. And if you want to choose randomly, you can just one click on this dice in here, and this will actually pick random color for you. But let's actually leave it for the surprise and hit recraft. Alright, as you can see, we have our icons, and I really like actually the result of this. I mean, the color choices is a little bit weird, using green and like violet in here or something. But you know, the idea is to have the same color for the six images or for the six like icons, which is really cool. And if you don't like one of them, you can just select the one that you don't like and hit recraft again. And this one too, let's select it and hit recraft, and it will generate like two more icons for you. But you can see how this is really cool and powerful for web design or for printing business cards or etc. So this is actually really neat. So we generate this thunderbolt. So this is the one that it has like rain, which can be really useful for like this icon. You can use it for like an application on a smartphone. So this is really nice. And this one, this is the other smartphone. Actually, I like this one more because I like the dots of the messages. So in overall, I really like this image set, and you can see the potential that you can create even more stuff with this using raster images or vector images too. So let's actually select this and put it right here. So the good thing about this artboard, you can actually create at the same time other things while you are in still with the artboard. You don't have to go back and create a new project unless you want to, of course. Alright, so the other thing that I want to do is to actually try this mockup. But before I'm gonna do that, I need to generate like a t-shirt design or something. So to do that, I will go directly to raster image, because I really like the style that we have in the raster image in the illustration in here. I really like this hand, no, not hand drawn actually, I like the bold sketch. The hand drawn is very nice, but my favorite is the bold sketch and the grain. Also, I like the 80s. But so let's go with the bold sketch because this is my favorite, and I'm gonna write like dragon drinking coffee. It's actually flying dragon is much better. So flying dragon drinking coffee, listening to music, wearing sunglasses. You need to have sunglasses if you are going to fly, no? So this will be our prompt for this design. So I have the style set to bold sketch. I'm not gonna mess with the color, and the size I will keep it the same. But if you want to actually edit the size, you can edit it in here. So I like the square, and if you want more resolution, you can just select this 1024 and maybe write 2000 for the width, and I'm gonna write 2000 for the height. All right. And as any other AI tool, this is actually very normal when it comes to this option where it say specific detail or specify details. You can actually make it very high to extreme to make like to leave like the AI be a little bit creative for you. So let's keep it in medium to see what we will get. And for the number of the images that I want to be generated, I'm gonna put it to 4, and then I'm gonna hit recraft and see what we will get. All right, I like that we have like very different colors from each one. So this is the first dragon, I think he already finished the coffee, and this is the second one. I really like the style of this bold sketch, so I like this one. And let's see this one too, it looks really nice. Actually, I really like this, and the one in purple. I like this and this. So I mean, all of them, they are really nice. So actually, let's make a copy and leave it aside in here, because we need to vectorize one, and when you do that, actually you will lose the other copies or the other images that you generated. So let's leave this copy in here for later. So I'm just gonna put it above the image set, and let's actually go and see which one that we will pick for our design. So I'm thinking this one or this one. Let's actually go with the blue for it to be more colorful. All right, so before we're gonna actually put this in the mockup, we need actually to vectorize it. As you can see, when I zoom in using Control or Command, while scrolling up, you see how blurry it gets because this is a raster image. So we need to actually vectorize it first, and then I will remove the background, and after that, I'm gonna put it in a mockup. So to do that, it's very easy. You can just right click on the image that you want to vectorize and choose vectorize. All right, now we have a vectorized image. As you can see, I can zoom in as much as I want and it will stay very crisp and sharp. All right, now the next step is to remove the background. So I'm just gonna right click again on the image and choose remove background. All right, as you can see, we have the image and a transparent dragon. And now we can actually use this to put it in a mockup. So I'm just gonna put this aside and then I will go back to create new and I will go for mockup and I will make this a little bit bigger. All right, something like this. And actually you need to actually generate the mockup that you want, and you can't actually change the style or something, so you can only generate what you want, for example white t-shirt, white hoodie, things like that. So let's go actually and type, let's go for like a green or like a red t-shirt and hit recraft. All right, as you can see, we have our red t-shirt. Let me just remove this, I don't need this one, I think. And so basically you can just take your design and drag it and put it inside the t-shirt in here and it will blend perfectly. As you can see, you can make it bigger or smaller, you can add text if you want. So for me, I really like how it looks. So you can see how powerful this is. You can actually generate the design and preview it on a t-shirt in the same time when you do that. So this is the mockup with the design that we just created now, and we have in it in a t-shirt. All right, so I think this is really nice, and that will be all for this video. I will make sure to put a link where you can find out more about this recraft, and don't forget to subscribe and comment and leave a like, and thank you for watching.